Hey guys, OG Silverback here. Hey, so I'm gonna start this video out with a disclaimer here. This video is for entertainment purposes. Neither the author, OG Silverback, or YouTube are responsible for any actions you take from the use of this video. The user and the person that's listening to this video is responsible for their actions, and neither OG Silverback or YouTube are asking you to follow this advice. This is just for entertainment purposes only, and me as OG Silverback, I'm sharing with you what I would do in a situation that could be particularly dangerous, so proceed with caution. Okay guys, so this is what's going on, man. So YouTube only limits me down to 30 minutes, man, and some topics are of such importance and such depth that you can't cover it in 30 minutes. And here's one about, you know, why TFLs and incels should invest in prostitution. This is part number 3. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to break it down for you here. And this is what I'm going to say, what TFLs and incels can learn from whores. That's what I'm gonna name it. So what I'm gonna do the format a little bit differently, guys. I'm gonna break this down for you in phases here because these are all teachable moments. But here's the video straight from YouTube, and I put the link on it. I want you to listen to it. I'm gonna commentate for you guys. Here goes. So here it is, guys. When the video first starts, this music video, the first thing you see is a stereotypical pimp on a Cadillac. And the video is kind of distorted, so I don't know if it's a yellow Cadillac or a pink Cadillac, but he's got a pink suit on. And this is stereotypical, and they got the female. This video was made in the 70s. They got the female dressed provocatively. Because the weapon of choice for women, dude, guys, is their sexuality. It's just the way that men are wired. We're very visual creatures from being hunter-gatherers. And when we see things, it does things to us physically. And a woman's body, that's why in a lot of Middle Eastern cultures, they make women cover from head to toe in a baggy, like, this is called an overall kind of a look from head to toe so you can't see because men are visual, right? This goes back to the beginning of time. And so the women's here are scantily clad. That's why women nowadays wear these yoga pants and Daisy Dukes and just all kind of revealing stuff, bro. Because they just wanna manipulate us based on our psyche. So here's the next portion, guys. So here comes the next part, guys. I want you to understand this: the importance of women's ego ed or women's self-identification. So the next part of the video, they're panning in on this fat white whore, dude. She is so fat. Like, she's the kind of fat, like, I'll be honest with you guys, being Hispanic and West Indian, bro, and Spanish, I love fat women. And I'm not saying like fat, like F-A-T. There's a thing called fat. It's called P-H-A-T. I'm gonna put that description from Wikipedia or maybe from the slang dictionary in there, but P-H-A-T stands for pretty, hot, and tasty, and that's a definition for a woman who eats a lot of rice and beans, whereas she has the typical what us Latino and guys that are from an Afro-Caribbean background, we like women with small waists and broad hips and a round fat ass, nice thighs, nice calves, pretty feet. Breasts, man, aren't really that important. Like, yeah, they're cool if they're like a B cup or a C cup, but all this double D stuff, man, I mean, no offense, it's like, that's a white dude thing, man. I mean, I don't really get into breasts and things, but if they got a fat ass, dude. So that's PHAT. But this whore is a fat white whore, like the kind of fat where, this would disgust me. If a woman's so fat, she's got what's called a muffin top, where the size of her stomach or her obliques bleed out like it looks like a mushroom, like a muffin, like an upside down muffin. And then her belly's so fat, dude, it hangs over her fucking vagina, bro. And then she's got a saggy, flat butt, bro, with cellulite. I don't like that. But that's how this fat whore looks. And the reason I bring this up is because women, bro, in America, even if the whore is fat and sloppy, dude, and looks like Quasimodo, bro, she has such high self-esteem because she knows the average guy, man, 80% of the guys want to put their dick up in there. Like, if nobody's around, nobody's looking, and nobody was telling you, most guys would put their dick up in there, right? And so these whores walk around like they're prima donnas, man. But you got to see how this whore is strutting her shit, man. Here we go, guys. So now they got Donna Summers, man. She's got these whores strutting behind her. And she's got on this, like, tight latex suit like the fucking dominatrixes wear for BDSM, man. And, you know, I'm just saying, bro. It's like, so they got the whole typical shit going on. And that's why I wanted to break this video down for you guys. Because music videos are telling you a story and the song is inculcating you with a way to view things, bro. Is fucking educating you and at the same time brainwashing you. So let's continue. So this is really an important reason that I'm breaking this down. These are teachable moments, dude. And like, when I ask you guys to watch my videos, you might watch them and I appreciate it, but I don't think that you're... This is what I learned in prison. I would rewind my life, dude. Like, I'd play my tape in my head when they locked me down at night, lights out. And I was a violent criminal, so I didn't have a cellie. And so I'm in there, and I'm playing the video of my life. And I'm playing the video when I shot the dude, right, in my head. But then I stopped the video, I paused it, rewind it. And I put it in slow motion, right? And that's what I leave you guys to do on these videos, man. You need to really take them in and understand them. So here's what Donna Summer's saying. She's saying, bad girls talking about the sad girls. So for those of you who are uninitiated or unenlightened, because you haven't really been following me for a long time, what they're doing is it's called MLK, mind control. So they want you to think that prostitutes are sad, bro. Like, they don't want to be prostitutes, right? That's what they want to... That's what America has been selling you guys, man. And I'm here to tell you this, dude. Like, out of all the women that are prostitutes, a large majority of them, that's what they want to be, dude, is prostitutes. So you got this... You got this false facade that, oh, you know, it's because they're on drugs and they're strung out that they got to sell their bodies to get drugs and this and that. Yeah, some of that may be true. But there's a lot of women just like to be on drugs, dude. Women are feeling creatures, bro. Women are all about their feelings. And that's what I'm trying to get you guys to understand. I'm trying not to get frustrated, man. But you young guys and some of you even middle-aged guys and some of you older guys live sheltered lives, dude. That's one thing I appreciate about growing up on the streets, bro. It taught me the reality of how shit really is, and it's not the facade that we've been sold. And women are feeling creatures. Anything that makes them feel good, they're going to do it, man. Do it until, you know, if it feels good, do it. That's a woman's mentality. The problem is, in America, most people have to work. Most men have to work to earn their keep. Women don't want to do that. Women have evolved into this party culture where they just want to party and have somebody else pay the bill and pick up the tab, dude. So what I'm saying is, in this portion of the video, she's talking about how bad girls are sad girls. I'm here to tell you they are not. They are some of the most happiest people because they get to suck dicks, get fucked in their ass, get fucked by different types of dicks. And they don't have to work for a living, bro. They get paid to fucking get pleasured, bro. And yeah, some guys treat them rough and treat them bad. But let me tell you something, man. A lot of women love rough sex. They love to get dude. They just, women are a dichotomy. They like to experience. Look, this is a woman. So I got something called lactose intolerant, right? And when I was a little stupid kid, I used to love ice cream, dude. But I would eat ice cream. It would give me like horrendous gas and diarrhea afterwards, bro. My stomach would hurt, right? But being a little dumb fuck kid I was, because all women are just fucking developed kids with a vagina and a breast and a clit. They just do, like, what women do, man, they'll fucking eat the ice cream, bro. They'll eat tons and tons of it, bro. Just tubs and tubs of it. And then when they got diarrhea and fucking flatulence, man, farting and stuff, then they want to complain about it, right? Here, let me tell you this quick story. So there was these construction workers, man. And then every day they would have lunch together. They bring their own lunches in a lunch pail. So they're sitting down all together. And then Bob opens up his lunch pail. And he goes, fucking tuna sandwiches, man. What the fuck? He goes, Fred, what do you got? Oh, I got peanut butter and jelly. You want to trade? Nah, Bob. Hey, what you got, George? Oh, I got a ham sandwich. You want to trade? Nah, Bob, I don't like tuna. What you got, George? I mean, John? Oh, I got a meatloaf sandwich. You want to trade, man? Tuna fish? No. So Bob's like, fuck, man. Fucking tuna fish. Hey, fucking tuna fish. That's on Monday. So Tuesday come. They have lunch. Bob opens up his lunch pail again. Fucking tuna fish sandwiches again. Fuck. I'm so tired of this fucking shit. And they go, guys, anybody want to trade? And he goes, nah, man. We told you we don't like tuna fish, dude. Don't ask us no more, right? So here comes Wednesday, guys. They all sit down. And Bob opens up his lunch pail. This fucking tuna fish sandwich. I'm so fucking tired of this shit. And then here comes the foreman. Well, Bob, if you don't like tuna fish sandwiches, just tell your wife not to make them. And Bob goes, I'm single and I stay by myself. I make my own lunch. And I'm positive for effect here, guys. So women, bro, they have immediate gratification. That's why there's a book out saying, train a woman like you train a dog, because a dog's attention span is only like 7 minutes. And women's attention span is the same way. Like, they're in the moment, guys. That's what you gotta understand. So however they're feeling in the moment, they will do whatever it is they want to do. And then later on, when it's time to suffer the consequence, they want to make excuses. And they never want to take responsibility, guys. Anyway, let's continue. So here it is. It comes down to the financials, guys. So what I'm teaching you, TFLs and incels, when you invest in prostitution, I'm teaching you to be a wise Wall Street investor like me, guys. This is what I learned when I got burnt on the stock market, guys. Like before, when I was making $200K a year, the money was just flowing in, dude. And this was back in 2000, bro. So you got to understand the economy, dude, and just, you know, it's a point of reference. So back then, I'm just saying to myself, in my opinion, $200,000 a year back in 2000, bro, that was like making $350,000 now. So I'm gonna just be honest with you. I get a check every 2 weeks. I had so much money, man. Back then, I was making like $10,000 every 2 weeks, right? So, dude, I had so much money on one fucking check. Dude, my check back then, they didn't have electronic, direct deposit. You get a fucking check. So, dude, I would get the fucking check from work. And one check, dude, would last me, bro, I'm not gonna lie to you, bro, it lasts me for about 4 or 5 months, bro, maybe 6 months, bro. So then my checks would pile up, and then the bank would contact me and be like, Mr. OG Silverback, if you don't deposit those checks, they're going to be voided out. So then I have to just put them in the bank, and I walked in the bank. The whores is, you know how you go to the teller and you punch into your number and you give your card? Man, when they used to see my account with all them zeros, the whores, I fuck so many bank tellers, dude. It's just ridiculous. But the point I'm making is it comes down to money. So I had so much money, I was investing in the two stock market. I didn't know what I was doing. So I lost a lot of money when the .com bomb crashed, dude. And so what I learned is this, dude. When you invest in anything, you want to put the minimal investment possible, because your investments is something that you can lose. So look at it like this, guys, and I'm going to make a video about it. But you want to split up your money, dude, into like, let's say, five parts. The first part is you pay your bills off. This is where you want to get to. The second part, the second fifth, is you put this in what's called long-term savings. Like, you never, ever, ever touch it, like, ever. Then the third part, you want to call that short-term savings. And you want to save for things like a vacation or, you know, a college or a car or something. Just, you know, you want to get in the habit of saving money, dude. That's like the key to being financially solvent. But here's the fourth, fifth, right? This is the one where you want to invest it in a business, dude. You want to invest in a business of your own, start your own business. With this online marketing and stuff, it's very, I'm not saying it's easy to do, but it's very feasible. And then the fifth is you invested into stock markets, invested into yourself. But that those type of investments are aggressive, and you have to be able to withhold losing that money. And so that's how I want you to look at prostitution, guys. So what I do is I invest the minimum as possible, and this is what I'm trying to impart upon you, the game that I've learned. And this, I did this from doing online dating, which is a fiasco, but I learned a lot from it. And I learned it from going out sarging, and I learned it from living in a lair, in a project. You know, we did Project LA, and then I learned by being part of a lair. And if I can't cover this all in this video, guys, you TFLs, incels, even the Mtow guys that are tired of being angry at women and tired of not having success with women, and you guys that are tired of being ripped off by PUAs, email me at ogsilverback971@gmail.com, and I'll just give you, like, some quick pointers, man. But the whole thing is this, guys. Over my metamorphosis of going from being in prison to getting married, becoming a fat bitch boy, and doing the pickup artist community, what I've learned is this, dude. When I invest in prostitution, I invest the minimum necessary so I can lose that. So here's what I've learned from doing online dating and sarging and going out at night and approaching women, all that bullshit that I've learned. This is what I've learned from it, guys. I meet a woman, man, and immediately try to get her on a coffee. I call it a meetup. But for women, I call it a date. Just because that's the only language they understand. And so if I can't do it right then and there, because sometimes I meet women, I'm going my way to work, or I'm going my way to the gym or the dojo or something, or I'm busy, then I get their number and I meet them up. I say, hey, let's meet at Starbucks, you know, and catch a cup of coffee, man, or some tea. So then when I get them there, dude, like, I'm looking to close them right then. So I get them in the Starbucks, bro. I'm immediately, it's called ABC, and it's from this movie called Glengarry Getting Lost. And then there's another one called Boiler Room. And even the Wolf of Wall Street is like that. But it teaches you, like, you always be closing, dude. So when you're dealing with a whore, you got to remember this, dude. Your job is to get your fucking cock up in her and to release your frustration, your aggression, and your stress, bro. And get that testosterone out to you for the minimum investment possible. Because it's all an investment. And you want to learn to trade in penny stocks. So I get the girl in a Starbucks, man. And I get her a tea or a coffee, whatever. I tell her like this, hey, check it out, you know what I mean? I know you're busy, I'm busy, it's nice meeting up with you here. Hey, but depending on how things go, you're going to get the next round. I get that immediately out of the way, because then she's not. I'm not spending a lot of money on the fucking horse. I know Starbucks, Frappuccino, Crappuccino, Pappuccino, with caramel, whatever, maybe it's like $6. So let's say 6 times 2 is $12. I'm in $12 to this whore. So I just tell the whore like this, hey, like, here, I saw you and everything, and you kind of like the look I like, you know what I mean? But I'm kind of like curious about you to know what kind of a person you are, because I'm not really looking to, you know, get my life turned upside down because I'm doing good for myself and everything. I'm looking for a woman who is open to adventure and who is, you know, sexually adventurous. Is not like stuck up on herself, you know, who likes to have fun. Does that sound like you? Well, that the whore doer talking, wah, 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 Charlie Brown, right? And so then from there, guys, what I'm going to tell her like this, hey, let's, you know, I've had a rough day at work. Let's go and have a drink. I know this cool place to have a drink. Let's go have a drink and continue our conversation. And then the whore's gonna go, it's called a change of venue. She's gonna go have a drink with me, bro. So you can check this out. The coffee already has us up, and she's got the drink in her. And I tell her like this, hey, because of my profession, I can't afford to have a drunk driver. What's your favorite drink? She's gonna tell. And I milk my drink, guys. I tell her like this, hey, the next round's on you. So I say, hey, remember I said the next round's on you? You're gonna get this round? Now, most hoes be like, hey, this is a different venue, man, whatever. She'd be like, all right, I'm gonna get this round. The next one's on you. So then you fucking talking to her. And you can use these words verbatim, guys, but it'll be like, hey, so, what's your favorite drink in the whole world? She'll tell me. And I go, hey, check this out. So, because of my profession, I really can't afford to get a drunk driver. And I'm starting to get a little bit, like, tipsy, kind of. Hey, let's say we take it back to your, let's pick up that favorite drink of yours, go back to your place and just continue talking. That way, you know, I have some time to metabolize the drink before I have to drive home. And then you be silent, bro. So then you want to get the whore to her house. I don't recommend your house, but you guys got to do what the fuck you want, man. I recommend the whore's house, bro. You know what I mean? There's arguments on both sides of the fence. I don't like taking whores in my house because, bro, it's too hard to get them out, and then they fucking be dropping by when I don't even want them to come by. So I got a whole different situation than you guys. I got whores just beating my fucking door down, but, you know, you guys do what you want. But what I'm going to tell you I do, I go to their house, bro. And then this is what I do. As soon as we get in the fucking door, you know what I'm saying? I have her give me a fucking tour. And I start making out with her, bro. Right then there, while we got the tour going. And then she'd be like, hey, man, you're moving kind of fast, man. I'd be like, yeah, man. Well, you're moving kind of fast. Like, get off of me. And then I'd push her off of me. And then we go ahead and crack open this drink that we got, her favorite drink, dude. And I say, hey, let's do it like in the movies. And we wrap arms around each other. You know how they wrap the drinks around each other. And then I drink and I smell her. And I go, hey, man, your hair smells really good. What is that fragrance? And I grab her hair. And I smell it, and then I just start kissing on her again, man, and I start working my way down, and I'm going to close them panties, bro. But that's my minimum investment. So let's just say I want to be honest with you guys. Sometimes I get to do the same night late. Other times it's just maybe she's on her period. Maybe she's trying to be my girlfriend. I don't know. Whores are funny, bro, but she won't let me smash that night. I'm not a rapist. I'm not Mike Tyson. I don't force myself on women. I leave, bro, and I don't fucking text her anymore. And this is how you gotta be, man. You gotta be this way. So then when she texts you, be like, hey, obviously, you're not trying to be the same kind of friend I'm trying to have. Because we're not in high school. You know me, we're adults. You know. I like you, I'm assuming you like me. So it's like, what's next on the agenda here, man? Like, you know what I'm saying? And then she'd be like, oh, you know, I'm trying to get to know. I said, look, you're gonna really get to know me like when we're intimate. Trust me. Let's get through all the bullshit, all the facade, all the fucking games, you know what I mean? Because this is one thing I know about women. This is what I tell women, guys. This is one thing I know about a woman. If a woman is interested in you, bro, she ain't going to make no excuses to have sex with you. The only excuse she's going to make is two. Like, one, she don't want to look easy, and two, she wants to be your girlfriend. But if a woman's into you, bro, she can have sex with you after 5 minutes. So then I just tell her like that, well, hey, when you're ready to be the kind of friend where you open, I told you I want a woman that's sexually adventurous, you know, and not frigid. And once you're ready to, like, you know, take that journey, text me back. And then I don't text no more. And I just go through women like that. I blow through them. So what's my investment? I did $12 at Starbucks, guys. And then I did, let's say a drink is $10, man. I did $20 at the fucking drink place. So 20 plus 12, what is that? 20... 30, that's $32, man. You know what I mean? Let's say she likes a bottle of wine. I bought some wine for her. Let's say $32. Let's say a bottle of wine. I spent $62. And I'm going to bang this whore, dude, until she gets to a point where she's tired of me not taking her to movies and taking her to dinner, bro. And that normally lasts for about a good 6 months, bro. And I just rotate through women like that. But let's continue on with this video. Yeah. So here's a teachable moment for you guys. This is what I learned, man, from when I was dating a lot. Now I just bang a lot. But when I, after I did my whole 5 years in the PUA and I really learned the skills, man, and I made them my own just from going out sergeant a lot, man. Friday nights, man, like women, man, that have to work, bro, they're frustrated because they've been sold a lie. They wanted to marry Prince Charming coming on the white horse, sweep them up. All they got to do is have a baby. They never got to work the rest of their life. So a lot of these single moms, dude, they're frustrated. They got a job that they hate. They got to work. And they're not making a lot of money. So everybody got this thing called TGIF. And this is what I learned, dude. Friday nights, man, is a good night to just practice what I've told you about these whores where you just meet them for a drink and just bang them. Because, dude, you want to save your Saturdays for getting fresh whores, bro. But Friday is a fucking magical night, dude. You could just bang whores because they had a long week and they just want to release, man. They just want to have a drink, do some drugs, and get fucked, bro. So remember that. And this is very important what Donna Summer says, guys. She's telling you the truth about women, man. They want to be a star. Every woman thinks she's a fucking star. Like, if, I don't know if you follow Instagram or Twitter or Snapchat or you just look at whores constantly. Hey, man, you ever look on a whore's phone? They take so many fucking selfies, dude. Like, what the fuck? Hey, I'm going to tell you something. Only time I take selfies is on special occasions, like the first time I'm out with a whore. You know, they'll be like, hey, let's take a selfie. I'll be like, all right, bitch, make sure you fucking text it to me. You know what I mean? Or if, like, me and my homies do something, like, really, really special, like go to a martial arts competition or a powerlifting or bodybuilding or a cage fight event or something, we'll take, like, a selfie like that. But I always get whores to take pictures of me, dude. I don't really do selfies. I think that's kind of, no offense, I just think it's, like, gay, wimpy, bitch boy shit. That's just me, though, homie. I'm old school. But whores take a selfie. Oh, I'm on the toilet. I'm brushing my teeth. I'm eating a, I'm drinking some coffee. I'm putting my Tampax in. I'm putting on a Kotex. It's fucking whores take selfies all the fucking time. Because they want to be a star, dude. But they don't want to put the work in behind it, man. That's why I made a video about Russell Wilson, man. Like, professional athletes put the work in behind become a star. And then they just go with any kind of whore. Because whores don't want to put the work in, bro. Now, this is the reason I really made this video, because Donna Summer says, now, you and me, they're both the same, and she's letting you know, even if you got a girl who goes to church, dude, or she's a fucking librarian, or she's a fucking nurse, or a fucking teacher, she's a fucking whore. You gotta, okay, I'm gonna calm down, because you guys get all scared. Guys, you gotta understand, women are whores. They are meant to carry our children. That's why they got this thing called alpha fucks, beta bucks. The whole thing, women just want to have sex with whoever they can, and then they want to find a chump to take care of the baby and let them just live a lifestyle where they don't have to work, and they can still go around fucking alpha males behind your back, or even if you're in your face if you're a cuckold. The reason the mama won't like it, because the mama was a whore, and she's hoping that the daughter don't turn out to be a whore. But a whore is a whore. It's innate in their nature, guys. And so this video is going kind of long. I think you guys got the message. You TFLs and incels, understand it's okay, it's honorable to pay prostitutes, bro, because you look at it like an investment to learn about women. And once you learn about women, you'll be able to treat them properly and put them in their place. Until next time, OG Silverback out.